Hello everyone, this is the Vaderman, and today is not quite a review, but more of a topic. Something I've wanted to talk about for a while, and it is... Well, I'll get to the point in just a second, but first, we all love the vintage collection. It is highly regarded as one of the best lines of Star Wars toys, especially within the Hasbro era, and it might be the very best, despite all the issues with getting the toys out and distribution. But I would stand here today and make the claim that the vintage collection has kind of ruined Star Wars collecting. Now, before you go into the comments and say how much you hate me and my ideas, hear me out. Yes, I love the vintage collection. It is by far my favorite of any of the lines, figure-wise. You know, maybe not vehicle-wise, Legacy Collection was pretty good. But overall, the vintage collection is hands down in the top two and possibly the first of the greatest lines of all time. And mainly because of the packaging. And old collectors love it because not only do you get a great figure, but you also have tremendous packaging to go with it, and younger fans like it because they want the figures inside. And at $10 a pop, yeah, it's a little expensive, but we were okay with it because you got such beautiful packaging. Fast forward to the Black Series. And people all the time are saying, I hate the packaging. The figures aren't even that good. Well, you know, they kind of are. I mean, one of the Black Series figures is literally just a retool of that one right there, so what's the problem? Well, the problem is the vintage collection. People were so used to great packaging and great figures inside. And when the Black Series started shipping out figures that were just as good as the vintage collection, some of them, you know, don't get me wrong, but people weren't buying them. A perfect example is Tauren Farr, a great figure just retooled from the vintage collection mold of Leia anyway, and yet I can still find her in the shelves today. Mainly because the packaging really, in my opinion, is awful. God-awful. Now, here's an interesting question to pose. If she was on a vintage collection card, would we see any of her? And perhaps the best example of this is my most hated of the Black Series, and that is Yoda. Yes, the one I've abused many a time on this channel. Is it a bad figure? Yes. Detail-wise, no, but articulation is absolutely piss poor. But would he sell on a vintage collection card? Yes, he would, in my opinion. I mean, yeah, because now you have a Yoda in box. It doesn't matter if the figure is absolute garbage. You have a good figure. So, there isn't really much to say, but when you really look at it, the vintage collection spoiled us to a point of we can't buy figures nowadays without kind of looking down on them. Like, oh, the packaging is all bland, and I will be the first to admit, I hate the Black Series packaging. And I don't think that we should settle for mediocrity. What I want to pose here is, should they, one, have never done the vintage collection and just gone straight to Black Series as not to spoil the collector, or should they have never gotten rid of the vintage collection? It can't be that expensive to pump out these cards. I mean, they could literally do this forever just with different characters. We never even got an Obi-Wan Kenobi, you know, a Ben Kenobi, old Ben, on a vintage card. So, you know, I'm just saying here, the possibilities for the vintage collection had not ended whatsoever. So why do you think, I mean, obviously they said they're going to bring it back, they're going to bring it back. Well, now might be the time. Maybe with the new movie coming out, that would be the perfect time. Really get the people into the new characters and new toys with old marketing and old packaging. So, when it gets right down to it, this video, like I said, not a review, it's just a question to you, the viewer. I have my stance on it. I think they really should have just kept the vintage collection forever, to be completely honest with you. I mean, yeah, you can pump out all your crappy 5 points of articulation you want for the kids. Keep doing that. But when it comes to the vintage collection and collector-focused toys, I couldn't tell you why they changed the packaging. But I don't care about my opinion, because I know my opinion, and it's boring. I want to hear your opinions. I want to hear, you know, good, bad, yes, no, I want to hear it all. So please, in the comments, discuss this heavily. I love reading these things. I have nothing better to do with my time. So go ahead. Do you think the vintage collection helped or ruined our collecting? And should it make a comeback and when? I'll be back with more reviews pretty soon. Sorry I've been gone for so long. Work kind of caught up to me and I haven't had a lot of time. I normally shoot these at 4 in the morning, but I've actually had to go to bed at a reasonable hour. So, you know. More will be coming. I'm going to shoot a bunch now. So until then, may the force be with you. Ugh.